Really good shot.
Not much forward. Birdie, as has Oosthuizen. Here's Woodland for birdie at one.
That's a little nervy start there on the green for Woodland. Love those shoes. It's going to be the hardest round of Gary Woodland's life.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Go get him, Gary. Go. Go.
That's a nice answer by Woodland.
After a drive of 325. That from 198.
He likes to cut the ball. He just doesn't want to overcook it here. And a great shot by Gary Woodland.
Justin Rose tied at the top. Here is Woodland at two for birdie.
It's a big putt. Yes. Nice to take the lid off early. And to birdie one of the hardest holes on the course. The hardest one today.
Indication of how Gary Woodland can feel here. You see him like to fade it like he did off the first two holes, and here a nice draw, three wood way down there.
From 96 yards, has to be careful coming up a little bit short right, severe downslope.
He likes it. Look at this. Woodland. Not backing down at all.
What a start for the 54-hole leader, Gary Woodland.
There's a beautiful picture of Gary Woodland's ball flight high. Lowest scoring on the front nine all week today.
What a good touch.
Yeah, that's a great touch, Curtis. And through three rounds, there's no player out here in this field that's made more feet of putts than Gary Woodland, over 350 feet. Second, right next to him is Justin Rose at 302 feet. Looming right behind him is Brooks Koepka.
You want to guard against a big miss left here. Any kind of miss left, and that's a beauty. Well, if he could have walked up and placed it there, he would have.
Lynn for birdie, our leader by two.
Gary! In the hole.
Good confident putt for Koepka there. Disappointing par.
Woodland taps in his par.
He's going with a long iron here. He did that yesterday. That's a bullet. Let's see if it
and
runs
it's also
out.
Way back, Paul. Way back.
Second shot for Gary Woodland at the par 5 sixth.
Boy, it takes a lot of courage to kick that ball out there to the right and bring it back. What a good shot. Thinned it.
Yeah, Paul came in really low and hot.
Yeah, he thinned it off that tight lie, Curtis.
Koepka parred number six, the par five, and Gary Woodland the same.
Oh,
And his first missed green of this Sunday. That will be left for his par. He has been a par saving machine at Pebble Beach.
Good iron for Woodland. I really think that putt he made on 7 is a real statement for Gary. Chance to drop a shot, make his first bogey.
Back at the 8th in Woodland.
That's a big 8 iron.
Perfect club there, Curtis.
Red line's the high line. If you hit it slowly, see which one he elects. Goes up high.
Well judged.
Just got it outside that red line by a second.
That's such a cool graphic.
It's a beautiful.
Here at 9, Gary Woodland, our leader now by 3.
It's got to be. Oh, it's a duck hook. Oh.
Thanks, man.
If his feet slipped, they did not.
That's just a defensive play with this hazard down the entire right side of this fairway.
Fantastic.
Trying to avoid making his third bogey of the championship from over 5 feet this week. It's to the right all the way. Things just get a little tighter.
Lead is down to 2.
Well, he put that tee shot on 9 behind him. Stripes it here off the 10th. That is perfect.
His lead is down to 1.
Pressure is really getting amped up on Gary Woodland now. He's won 3 times, Joe. He knows what it feels like to try to win. He'd be pretty happy with that one. Not even that clown behind him could distract Gary Woodland at this point. Some guy waving a sign back there. I don't know what that's all about. But.
I love this play. It's a big show of confidence. But again, just like Rose, he's going to miss it into the right rough. That was a hard swing
way up in the air.
Are you kidding me? That's the
unbelievable
best.
There.
Curtis, there are not many players that could do that shot.
And more power to get this out.
And Shane, it's really hard to control the distance your ball goes when you have that much speed in the open-faced club.
All things considered, real solid par for Gary Woodland.
That settled in some deep rough, and he's going to have to go over that bunker, then down the hill.
Great shot. That's just sometimes you have to take your medicine.
Well, it landed right on the front of the green from him, and impossible.
We mentioned Woodland's run of two bogeys in this championship when he arrived at the ninth. He has now made two bogeys over his last four holes.
That is no good. The hole's on the right.
Way to the right.
Big bunker protecting it, Curtis, and might get a break there. He's got a little bit of a lie, but still no chance to get that close. That is something special.
Here's Woodland at 13.
That is some kind of par, Joe, from where he drove it.
He is even par for this final round and will hold there through 13.
That looked like a much smoother, much slower transition. And just like anybody else under pressure, the swing can tend to get short, Joe, and
going at the front left bunker. Carried it.
What a shot that is. That is blasted 263 yards to the hole. That's a 255 yard carry uphill. And I got to tell you, it's cold out there. That way you'll never dump it. That's okay. Not great. Got a little work left.
What a birdie.
Boy, he just calmly stepped up there and rolled that in.
Just 220, 230 off the tee. That's another one.
He loves it. And Zing and Curtis, I can't help but thinking, in 1992, Tom Kite playing the final day, took a 3-wood out on 14. Mike Carrick, his caddy, made him go because he knew he could get at that front bunker. I'm surprised that we didn't see a fade here like this, letting the wind help it. Can't get all the way to the shelf. Needs to go another foot.
And just about gets it. One more look at that. How close to a three-shot lead.
Yeah, Shane, and it races away a little bit here at the end. But what a good putt. Solid as it can be right there, right up the hill. Didn't look like 3.5 feet. Felt like 10.5 feet for Woodland. Curtis, I think the fact that he doesn't have to hit a driver these last three of the last four holes, obviously not 17, but he can hit the stinger right there like he did on 15. He can do it on 18 if he's got a lead.
Good contact, good looking shot.
Beautiful play by Woodland. He actually had a shot out of a divot on number four on Friday. Hit that same sort of shot. Well, that stayed in the map the whole time. Hard to hit it up that hill.
and just what he needed to do. Simple par at 16 for Woodland.
Right side of the green.
That is not a good shot at all. And he's probably going to have to pitch that ball off the putting green. Sounded great. Oh, look at the shot.
Zing, we talked about off the tee how that was maybe the biggest swing and shot of his life.
And clip that ball, no divot whatsoever.
Sweep the leg, Gary!
And watch it check right there.
Beautifully played. Another well played layup.
Safely on in three. Got it! A major champion, Gary Woodland, has won the U.S. Open.